It's WRVS 89.9, your community voice and your home of Cheryl Underwood Radio, tonight and every weeknight at 10. Clay Mercer here with you. And, of course, you're listening to Afternoon Delight Radio Show. And we've got some special guests on the line with us today. And if you joined us on Thursday, we had a real special occasion here on the campus of ECSU as we introduced the brand new head coach of the ECSU women's basketball program. And right now on the line to talk about that and so much more is the athletic director here at ECSU, Mr. George Bright, and the new head coach of the Lady Vikings basketball program, Ms. Tanisha Lewis. Coach Lewis and AD Bright, welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me.
Clay, thank you so much. This is exciting for us. We're so glad to work with WRVS and you and make this happen. Clay, you've been great to us, man, and thank you so much for all the great things you do for the Department of Athletics.
Oh, man, it's hand in hand. I truly appreciate the opportunity to speak with the both of you, and we're going to talk a lot about everything that's taking place and all the excitement here on the campus and the alumni and everything that took place on Thursday. Coach Lewis, I want to bring you in. Your experience as a player in the ACC and the WNBA has been well documented. How will that experience assist you with your duties as head coach?
Well, I like to call myself a player's coach. I try to coach the way that I would want to be coached as a player. Coach Al, I mean, I say all the time that I was blessed to even play for her, to learn for her, to watch her, to emulate how she coached, how smart she was, how always she was prepared. She knew her players. She knew the opponent. So definitely well-prepared under her and Coach Glantz, and then the opportunity at North Carolina Central University under Trisha Stafford Odom. Very few times that you have opportunity to work under someone who would allow you to implement your ideas and support you in those ideas, and then to see them working. So well-prepared in that arena. And then as the WNBA to play at the highest level, so many analytics types of things that you see that you can break down within the game, breaking the game into smaller pieces, just making the game slow down, and then being able to teach it and playing with some of the best players, the best minds, Tina Thompson, Dawn Staley, Cheryl Fluke, Vivian Cook. I mean, like, just the knowledge that I've had around me, that I still have around me, to learn from and to pull from, is going to be essential in making sure we do the right thing here at the Elizabeth City State University.
And Coach Lewis, I'm glad you brought up the word preparation. It actually leads us to our next question. You've held positions as an assistant coach, and now you're a head coach for the first time. What can you take from that experience specifically that will prepare you for this next challenge?
Well, I always believe if you can't follow, you can't lead. If you can't serve, you can't lead. Mm-hmm. And just knowing when to do things and how to do things and being in a place where you're always learning. I don't ever feel like just because you're a head coach that you stop learning from other people who've done more, who are doing the same thing. And also, obviously, my players have taught me so much about how to coach them, and how you can't coach every player the same way. How to find the little motivations of each player and being able to push the right buttons to get what you need for the team. Playing point guard also helps with that as well. You know, I say all the time, I tell the story all the time, having a 6'3", 6'5", Summer Herb on my team. She was a teddy bear. And then I had one of my teammates, my roommate, you know, you could pretty much say anything to her in the world and she'll still fight. But I had my teddy bear, Summer Herb, 6'5". I mean, you couldn't even whisper to her, and she'd fall out of pieces. So I had to figure out how to get what we needed out of her, figuring out the right way to talk to her and, you know, push her as well. So being able to adjust depending on what the player needs, I mean, that's important as well. And you know, also being a teacher at some point, eighth grade math teacher, I promise, just understanding that this is a different generation than who we are. Trying to expect the same thing that you would do from them is kind of, it's going to set you up for trouble. So just trying to make sure we're getting to know the kids, knowing these young ladies, what they need to be pushed, how they need to be pushed, and then making it work.
This afternoon, Delight Radio Show. Yours truly, Clay Mercer here with ETSU Athletic Director George Bright and the new head coach of Lady Vikings basketball, Coach Tanisha Lewis. And Coach, after Thursday's press conference, you had a chance to chat with the current members of the women's basketball team. Take us inside of that conversation. How was your initial meeting with them?
Well, it was short, but it was great. I mean, Thursday was a blur, they're great, great, they're great girls. And they've embraced me, so I appreciate that because they didn't have to do that. They're ready to work. I'm sending out some things to them this week. I talked to each one of them individually this week. I spoke to most of their parents because, you know, it's a big deal for a new coach to come in. And, you know, there's a person that you did not know that did not recruit your kid that is now coaching them. So I just wanted to introduce myself, who I am. Pretty much what you see is what you get, pretty honest, about as honest as it's going to get, and that I'm tough, but I'm fair. So, you know, it was great talking to them, just getting their perspective, what their goals were after basketball, and making sure that that I can do everything in my power to make sure that they have a great experience here at Elizabeth City State University.
Coach, you're very accomplished off the court, holding 4 academic degrees. Man, what drove you to continue pursuing your goals in higher education?
One of the greatest lessons I learned was in the WNBA my third year. I had one of the greatest off seasons I think I could ever had, and I was playing really well. I fuss at Cheryl Foos all the time about this, but I was killing her in training camp. I don't care what anybody say. And Cynthia Cooper decided to come out of retirement. And Cynthia Cooper's contract takes up 3 of our contracts. So when she decided to come back, we got that good phone call. Hey, Tanisha, could you come upstairs and talk to Van Chancellor? I was like, well, what do you want to talk to me about? So I get up there to the office, and he's like, you know, I don't have a bad thing to say about you, but we don't have the money to keep you. And I was distraught. Mm-hmm. And, you know, one of the worst things you can do is call your mama crying.
That's true.
I'm tore up. I said, Mama, they cut me. I'm not going to play in the league anymore. She's like, come home. Forget them. I'm like, Mom. So what I figured out is that by the time I got on the plane and pulled myself together to come back home, I already had a job offer for to work at the State Bureau. I was trying to be on CSI back then, at the State Bureau of Investigations. And that was because I already had degrees then. So that revelation was that basketball is great. It's beautiful. And it can take you a lot of places. But if you don't have the foundation of education, you're going to be in trouble.
I love that.
So what I want for every young person, especially young ladies, is to have options. And then granted, I didn't go to the SBI because I got picked up by Charlotte like a few days later. But to have that security that regardless if this didn't work out, I could still, you know, take care of my family and live a life that my family can be proud of, you know, sort of can kind of, you know, reveal to me that, you know, basketball's great, but this education is not an option.
I love that. Words that all the listeners need to hear. Thank you for that, Coach Lewis. And again, you're listening to Afternoon Delight Radio Show. And A.D. Bright, I want to bring you in right now. And I'm sure there were many candidates for this position. Aside from her history on the basketball court, what made Coach Lewis stand out from the rest?
Well, you can clearly hear Clay in what she's saying. Coach Lewis is the right coach for Elizabeth City State University at this time. You know, coaches have a critical, positive, and significant impact on the lives of student-athletes. We know that. We've all experienced it. And it's no different than here at Elizabeth City State University. Like I said, we've got the right coach. You know, we started that process, Clay, back in March. And, you know, with the search committee, we discussed what I thought were the critical needs for the program's success. Mm-hmm. And if you remember, that's the same time that this COVID-19 began to come up too. So, you know, we were able to make it happen through landing, I think, what I would call a terrific candidate. She's an educator. a motivational speaker. You hear it.
Mm-hmm.
You talked about our academic and educational experience. You know, she's very, you know, shy about it. But if you look at all those stats down at the what happened with Coach Yao and at the Wolfpack with the NC State Wolfpack and all the things that she accomplished there, taking the team deep into the Sweet 16 and maybe even the Final Four.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we had a strong pool. Yeah, Final Four, yeah. We had a strong pool. We had a great pool, all right? But I'm thankful that emerged from this pool is this terrific person that is now our head coach at Liberty City State University. I mean, we wanted to find a head coach that was incredible,
mm-hmm.
a leader for our women's basketball program that was great. And to me, there were some non-negotiable. You've heard me talk about
That's
it.
Right.
I want somebody that, you know, we wanted to find a leader that had incredible respect for our student athletes, of course, for our community, for our department, you know, everything. I also wanted to find somebody with incredible integrity. I got that. Somebody that has terrific determination. You hear it. I only have to talk about that. And, of course, excellence is a part of her package. So, you know, but again, I think what we don't know about Tanisha Lewis is that she's somebody that's going to bring people together, okay? She's going to motivate the team. She's going to be able to talk to the team when the moments aren't so great and be able to bring them and lift their spirits out. And that's the kind of person that I'm looking for. You know, I think we're going to see an up-tempo play. Coach, you can talk about that. And, you know, of course, she played at the high level. But what I love is the conversation that we've had about her being student-athlete-centered and focused and understands what our championship vision is and wants to help us get to that championship culture we all desire. So that's the person I think that we have that's sitting at the helm of our women's basketball program. And I'm excited that we've got the right coach at the right time here at Elizabeth City State University.
It's afternoon daylight radio show on WRVS 89.9. And Coach Lewis, I'm sure everyone is intrigued about the brand of basketball you're bringing to ECSU. What can all of us and the fans expect to see on that basketball court next season?
Definitely fast paced. I was telling the young ladies that, you know, I didn't say it correctly. I said, we're going to run. And all their eyes got big. I was like, we're going to have an up-paced tempo. So they're like, ooh. I said, but trust and believe, the foundation is running in the beginning.
Yeah.
You know, build the foundation during preseason. I said, you can't guard if you're tired.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, that's what separates a lot of players at the end of the game where the jump shots are short and shots that normally go in don't go in. It's because we got tired at the end. So, definitely up-tempo. We want to press. We want to change defenses. We want to push the ball. We want to get easy shots, but we're going to take smart shots. We're going to be great time managers of the game. They're going to be smart. They're already super smart, but teaching them the game, what a good shot is, what a good shot is not, when to take those shots. In my time in the NBA coaches program, I can't remember the NBA coach, but he talked about the analytics of the game, the first, the last 3 minutes, baseline out of bounds, sideline out of bounds, the importance of stealing points here and there. And so definitely pushing the ball up the floor, taking good shots, getting the ball to the right person at the right time. We've already talked about if somebody has hit two shots in a row, I promise if they don't touch it that next play, it's going to be a rough time. So, you know, things like that. And then, you know, we in it together. You know, like it's all of us. We win together. We lose together. We fix it together. So
right.
That's definitely our mindset that we're trying to instill that, you know, we can do this. We will do this.
You made a statement also, Coach, during the press conference about being a product of the 252 and the chance to return
yes.
and serve the 252. Why is that
yes.
so important to you?
Oh, my God. Listen, that came from two caution lights, like both of them yellow. Like, we didn't even have a stoplight, right? Riding the tractor to the store to get my death
yeah.
Let's see, one policeman, and he worked part-time at a gas station. I mean, this is like the idea that I could come back to what helped create me. Like, 252 is known for being hardworking, so may not have everything, but can create anything. That's what we're known for.
Mm-hmm.
And so the idea to come back home and to give back something to the community that helped make me. Like, I played over here at Bertie and Hereford. Now, they never beat me. Let me put that out there. They never beat me. But, you know, I played against Hereford, Bertie. I mean, I remember Nikita Askew from Bertie County. I mean, she could jump out of the gym. But, like, the idea to be able to serve a finally, like, my brother and I have been doing it with It's Doable, my nonprofit I started my second year in the WNBA, where we've been doing Edgecombe, Nash, Wilson County, and we're definitely coming to Pasquotank County, book bag, good giveaways, winterware giveaways, different things in the community, food drives, just because we were just raised like that. You know, nobody has to teach me how to serve. That's just how I was raised, mm-hmm. to be grateful for everything. And for the people who didn't, nobody has to do anything for you. And the fact that, you know, growing up at Macclesfield, North Carolina, how the community rallied around each other and helped us become who we are. So the idea of being in 252 is so exciting. I am ready to get started. And, you know, the biggest thing now is just trying to find somewhere to live, and we're working on that. But, you know, I was talking to the missions director today, and he's like, he's excited. I said, y'all can't be as excited as I am. Mm-hmm. So I'm just ready to get moving and working and being a part of the community, get to my favorite part, the basketball court, and get my hands on these kids. But, you know, I'm just excited to be able to give back to someplace that has given me so much.
The Afternoon Delight Radio Show. Don't forget, you can find us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter at WRVS899. Clay Mercer here with Athletic Director George Bright and the head coach of the Lady Vikings basketball program, Tanisha Lewis. And AD Bright, I want to bring you back in here. And you talked a little bit about COVID-19 and the coronavirus and the impact that it's had, you know, not only in the community, but here on the campus, the university. I'm sure it's placed some uncertainties on the upcoming sports season. How difficult has it been for you to navigate through these uncertain times?
Well, it's been certainly a significant challenge. But first, let me say, it's so hard to not for us to have had that spring season, Clay, and our student athletes. I just felt so bad to have to break that message that we weren't going to have a season. So, you know, I'm always student-athlete-centered and student-athlete-first. I want to make sure that they have a great experience. And it just was hard to put ourselves in that position to say that, you know, we're not going to have it. That being said, Clay, there are just so many more questions than answers for what we'll have in terms of, you know, what's going to happen in the fall. Every day there's information coming out from the NCAA and, of course, from other entities as well. So I think as we approach this season and hopefully the numbers don't spike, we're able to get some modification of a season in the fall. To me, I hope we'll be able to play, but if we do, there'll be some sort of different scenario where, you know, social distancing plays a significant part in what it is that we do.
Seems like our new normal right now. And as we continue to progress through this time, I know that we're continuing with initiatives here on the campus. And I want to take a little bit of time to bring awareness to the Reimagine Roebuck campaign. It's an initiative to repair the football field and improve the stadium. If you could take a little bit of time to tell the listeners more about it and how they can show support.
Well, we appreciate it. Thank you for taking the opportunity. You know, as we look towards the future, we want to take the opportunity to take a really good look at Roebuck Stadium and do what it is that we can do together to fix the stadium to the capacity that we all would desire. You know, we thought that when we took a look at the football field this past, at the end of the season, we knew something had to be done. So I'm very thankful to our leadership, our chancellor, executive cabinet, and others that said, yes, let's try to renovate the field if we can. And I'm also very thankful for those donors that have already contributed to this project that are helping us move it forward. Our Day of Giving is coming up at the end of this month in May, and we want to encourage people to join and participate not through the Day of Giving to help us get to where it is. So the Reimagined Roebuck campaign is the renovation of many areas of Roebuck Stadium. We've already started on the field. But down the road, if we get the funding and we get the ideas and get the dreams ready to go, I would imagine that we could do things like fix up the track, fix up the scoreboard, work on our concessions, the press box, our event space, some of the seating areas, just to make it more feasible in terms of what the dream can be. But right now, you know, the field itself, we've had an opportunity to raise some funds for that, to provide a safe and healthy field for our team, of course, to compete on, but of course for our band, our Sound of Class band, to perform on. You know, the field itself is something that we're excited about. As we move forward, we ask all of our listeners, if you can help us with this, please do so. We started with a 500 people get $500 each to raise a goal of $250,000 for a football field. So if you can help us with that, that's great. But if you can't do 500, do whatever you can. We'll be able to use that to move this project forward.
That's right. And listeners, you can learn more about this campaign through social media at ECSU Vikings, as well as online at ECSUVikings.com. You're listening to Afternoon Delight Radio Show. Yours truly, Clay Mercer, here with ECSU Athletic Director George Bright and the brand new coach of the ECSU Women's Basketball Program, Tynisha Lewis. And Coach Lewis, I want to bring you back in as you prepare for the first season as head coach here at ECSU. What are some of the short-term goals you have for yourself and the team?
Preparing for a preseason, making goals for preseason. Personally, raising some money for the kids, make sure they have a great experience. Thirdly, also just preparing for the season, setting goals, have our individual meetings, and also hiring staff. That's important. And also the volunteer staff. Those are the top four things that I'm working on right now. I already met with all the players. I'm going to schedule a Zoom meeting probably the 1st of June just to talk to them, let them know what our goals are, our team meeting, and, you know, work together in creating their own personal goals for the year. So those are the short-term ones that we're working on right now.
Sounds good. And, Coach, I can hear it in your voice. I know you're looking forward to meeting those challenges that lie ahead. And I believe I can safely say this for all of the ECSU faculty, staff, and students, the fans, and the alumni. I think we are all excited about having you here as the leader of the ECSU Lady Vikings women's basketball program. Coach Lewis, A.D. Bright, thank you both so much for joining us here today. And I look forward to catching up with you all soon.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. We appreciate your support.
Yes, feel good followers. Make sure you stay tuned. More of the music you love is on the way. You're listening to Afternoon Delight Radio Show.